In the vast Saharan desert, one of the many famed locations are a series of oases where water seemingly has ponded along with trees and vegetation in one of the world's driest locations. What you are generally not expecting to see at an oasis is a potentially active, albeit likely dormant, volcano. Yet, one such location exists in a country typically not associated with volcanoes, Libya. There, even visible from satellite, is a large black patch which heavily contrasts with the color of the surrounding desert landscape. Known as Wa'an Namus, this unique and isolated volcano at some point produced a catastrophic eruption which coated the surrounding landscape in ash and led to the formation of a 3.9 kilometer long, 2.9 kilometer wide, and 140 meter deep caldera. Since a caldera floor is below the top of the water table, several small lakes formed. However, due to the remoteness of Wa'an Namus, it presents a number of mysteries. For example, despite the lightly eroded appearance of a black tephra layer which surrounds the volcano for many miles, the youngest rock on the volcano to be reliably dated was 200,000 years old. Yet, if we compare it to another widespread volcanic deposit in a similar environment, albeit one that has a little more rainfall, something does not add up. At the Pinakit volcanic field in Mexico, the El Elegante crater is dated at 32,000 years old. Yet, the tephra field at Wa'an Namus appears to have experienced a similar or even lesser amount of erosion. This suggests that at least one eruption at this volcano possibly could have occurred as recently as during the last 25,000 years. Because of this uncertainty, it is difficult to classify this volcano as extinct, dormant, or active. It could be any of the three categories, as more studies are needed on this complex. However, for the sake of this video, we will assume it is dormant, meaning it has not erupted during the Holocene period, but could theoretically erupt again at some point in the future. The Wa'an Namus volcano is located in south-central Libya, where it is 344 kilometers west-southwest of the city of Tazerbu. At great distances to the south are a series of volcanoes in the nation of Chad, which likely owe their existence to an underlying mantle hotspot. While Wa'an Namus might also owe its existence to a hotspot, another distinct possibility exists. In the section of Libya where Wa'an Namus is located is a feature referred to as the Sirt Basin. This basin is slowly spreading apart due to extensional forces to the northeast and southwest. This has over time created basin and range-like topography, potentially allowing for magma to intrude into the crust and erupt via a path of least resistance. One of these weak points in the crust appears to be a chain of activity which has resulted in volcanic features along the southeast trending line, which Wa'an Namus is a part of, and even includes features which look somewhat similar to Mar explosion craters. Based on the area the black tephra covered, which totals approximately 237 square kilometers, it can be assumed that it originated during the caldera-forming eruption of this complex. Whenever this eruption occurred, it likely involved a large quantity of intruding magma, which when it interacted with overlying groundwater, generated a powerful explosion. A Plinian eruption then occurred, and as a plume of ash shot high into the atmosphere, part of the eruption column collapsed downwards and generated long traveling pyroclastic flows which traveled as much as 13 kilometers distant. Then, due to the large amount of erupted material, Wa'an Namus's underlying magma chamber was significantly drained. This caused a large section of overlying rock to collapse downwards to fill the empty space, forming its modern caldera. Phreatomagmatic eruptions then commenced and through semi-continuous explosive activity built its central tuff cone. Several more forming eruptions then occurred to the northwest, which overlaid existing plaque tephra deposits. Although this volcano may never erupt again, if it was to erupt, the most likely sequence of events would create another Mar explosion crater. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Astrid Mullenberg for becoming a channel member on YouTube of Geology Hub.